Hello and welcome to Friday Fundamentals. This week has been a particularly stressful week for me, and I know that, you know, there are lots of people out there who are stressed as well. We're in very unusual times. And I just wanted to take a moment to leave a message for those who may be struggling, especially if you're on your own and you maybe have been on your own for a while. I wanted to really offer you some hope. I know it can be a challenge, especially when you're on your own and things are going wrong. Real big things seem to be going wrong. To get caught up in it all and think that, you know, there isn't a way out. I just want to remind you how resilient you are, how much strength you have. And I do believe we don't get challenges that we can't overcome. And personally, I know that, you know, there are times when you think you just can't go on, you haven't got the strength or the energy that's been called for. And it's in those times that it's really worth taking a step back. If in any way you can find some time and space for yourself. And what I mean by that is, you know, even if you're on your own, get out of your usual environment and take some time to just be with nature or just be in a coffee shop with a different energy and journal or do whatever works for you to just be with what's there for you. We so often, or rather I so often, can get caught up in the emotion, in the thoughts. My mind is very, very busy. But if we look at this time, if you look at it from a spiritual or evolutionary perspective, an evolution of consciousness, our egos are fighting with their last breath to keep us earthbound and in the doing, in the busy, in the fear. You know, our ego is designed to keep us safe. And with all of the chaos and energies around us right now, our egos are going a bit mental. And if you can step back from that ego and recognize that voice in your head that's causing you so much stress and anxiety is what's keeping you in the problem. Yeah, I'm not saying that the problem will immediately disappear. But when you step back and you step into that different energy of your intuition and your true guidance from source, creator, God, whatever you want to call it, that's where the real wisdom comes from. And that's where you can put things in perspective. So even though you're up against it, you have all the power, because it won level or another, in terms of choices, energy, unconscious, we kind of got here because it's something we needed to learn. It's something that maybe we've been repeating a pattern, and I know for me that's definitely what it is. And it's time to overcome that pattern, and the only way to do it sometimes is for everything to break down so you can rise up. And I know that might sound harsh, but if you're, I know it's not dismissive in any way of what you're feeling. You know, I've really had my moments over the last week, but it is about acknowledging that you are the only person that can really get you through this. And you have all the help, all the resources you need as soon as you open to acknowledge them and then to receive them and to ask for help where you can. I know that's been a huge block for me, but I'm asking for help. I'm looking for help where I can right now. And I am focusing on getting through this in such a strong way that I can support others who are facing the same thing. One of the ways is to journal not just about, you know, thoughts that come up, but having some prompts that really help you acknowledge how strong you are, things you've overcome before. I mean, if you take one journaling prompt today, just list 5 times where you thought you were never going to make it through. 5 times in your life, 5, you know, back against the wall times, and notice what happened and how you rose from that and created and moved forward, and how you can take those elements of what you did then and apply them to perhaps where you are today. I hope that helps. Have an amazing Friday, have an amazing weekend, and I'll see you on Monday for Monday Motivation. Please do like, share. It does help the channel. And if you can follow or subscribe, that would be brilliant. Also, if you're interested in the journaling course I'm putting together, I'll put the link in the show notes. But also, if you're interested, you can either leave a comment, DM me, or email me. Have a brilliant weekend. Bye for now. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this week's episode. If you enjoyed it or think it would be valuable to others, please do share. And if you really enjoyed it, please leave me a review. It really helps the podcast. All of the links are in the show notes, and I look forward to seeing you next week on the Choosing Happy podcast.